Hello.
Yeah, it's just driving down here slow, he said. Yes.
I was going to call you back, but I figured I'd wait to the face-to-face. Micah, make a note, all these batteries are low. Try the red one.
Check. Testing, can you hear me? Needs to be a little bit louder, I think. If you, yep.
They want me to test all the mics. Can you hear, yep, you can hear that one? Testing, yes.
Testing.
So Miss Davis is coming. They're walking. As soon as they get here, we'll get started. Are y'all excited? I'm excited. Right here. I got a row for you right here. Right here. I got an empty row for you right here. Right there, the empty row. I got you right here. Okay, we'll get started. I need you to be quiet, please. Thank you. This is the 11th grade drama class is getting ready to perform to you the Red Tie Club. There are some funny things in there, so you can laugh. But do pay attention to what they're saying, because there is an underlying message behind this little skit that they're putting on. So, and I hope you'll catch that. We hope you will. We hope you enjoy it. I just want to remind everybody out here that, you know, there is no need for you to make fun of the kids that are on the stage, because every single one of you will have to take my drama class, and you will have to do it. So, right, 10th graders, because you're next, right? Let's not be making fun of them. They've worked really, really hard and have worked hard all semester, and I'm proud of them, proud of what they're doing. So, if you'll please be quiet, we'll get started.
Excuse me, I need to get in.
I'm sorry, sir. You can't come in. Members only.
Well, how do you know I'm not a member?
This is the Red Tie Club. You aren't wearing a red tie.
But I'm expected.
Your name?
Jack Marius Tech Theratrix.
What?
Jack Marius Tech Theratrix.
That Jews make.
Jack Marius Tech Theratrix. It's not that hard, man.
Sir, I'm sorry. There's no Tech Theratrix.
This is insane. I'm supposed to meet some friends inside for a dinner engagement. I'm late already.
Sorry, sir. You can't come in dressed like that, regardless of who your friends are.
Hold up. What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
This is the Red Tie Club. You need to have a red tie to come in.
That is ridiculous.
It's the rule. Nobody gets in the Red Tie Club without a red club tie.
Look, oh my goodness. You gotta let me in. Look, this is how I help you? Like, look the other way while I just slip right in there?
You cannot buy your way in, sir. I work for the richest man in town. Bribes mean nothing to me.
Do you know who I am?
Yeah, Jack Mears, Tech Theratrix. You forgotten who you are?
No, I mean, you don't know who you're dealing with. I'm friends with the mayor, and all the city councilmen know my name. Now let me in before I call them and tell them that you're disrespecting their friend.
The owner is richer than all of them, and is no respecter of persons. No amount of contacts can get you in the Red Tie Club. Nobody gets in the Red Tie Club without a red club tie.
Look, I can get a red tie later, but I need in right now. My friends are probably waiting at the table for me. Go ask them. They'll vouch for me.
I'm sorry, sir. Nobody inside has any influence on who gets in.
Look, I really need to meet with these men. My financial future could depend on getting this contract. Can't you let me in?
I'm sorry, sir. Nobody gets in the Red Tie Club without a red club tie.
Look, I'm just as good as any of the people already in there. Better than some, even. It's not fair that you let some in and just keep others out.
On the contrary, sir. That's the only fair way to let anybody in. It makes all even, given the fact that you only get in with having a red tie.
Just get out of my way, tomato dumpling. Report me once I'm in.
Look, trying to force your way is useless, man. I'm much stronger.
Well, listen, when I was 7, I took karate. And not to brag or anything, but I was a yellow belt. So, I'm getting through that door. Anaconda squeeze!
What is wrong with you? Sir, you're just gonna hurt yourself. No one's ever gotten past me, around me, or through me.
Oh, no kidding. It's because you're a fat brick wall. What do I have to do to get in?
Sir, nobody gets in the red tie club without a red club tie.
Yeah, I get it. You're real big on repeating that. Thanks for nothing, pal. You won't be seeing the last of me, Mr. High Money Doorman. Oh, what's up, ladies? Y'all care if I... Okay. Hello, ladies. Enjoy your visit.
Thank you.
Not on the town with my lady.
Whoa, what are you doing?
What are you talking about?
Can't get on the coattails of others?
Bro, you can't blame a guy for trying, can you?
It's been tried before. Don't think you're looking for a back door either, sneaking in. This is the only way in.
Yeah, thanks for the tip, pal. But you won't be getting one from me for it.
Good one.
I know. I need a red tie. But I don't know where I can get one real quick. Wait a second. If I can't find a red tie, then I'll just make one instead. Let's see what's in here. Don't know what that is. Water bottle? I'm keeping that one. Oh, snap. An egg McMuffin. Only one bite out of it, too. It's amazing what people just throw away. It's good stuff. Aha! This here ought to get me in. There. All right. Oh, gosh. Hope nobody smells me, though. It's a crummy piece of cloth. Oh, Lord. It's real rank. Look, man, I've kept the rules, see? I've got a red tie.
I'd hardly call that a proper tie, sir.
Hey, I made it myself. That ought to show you that I'm trying to keep your rules, even if, even more than if I went out and bought one. Doesn't my effort count for anything?
Actually, sir, all it shows is your inability to abide by the rule. Your own efforts count for nothing.
You know what? I've had it. What's your name, mister?
Delaw, sir.
Yeah, spell that for me, please.
D-E-L-A-W, okay. Delaw.
Okay. Well, Mr. Delaw, I'm reporting you to the manager. You've demeaned me and made me feel like a second-class citizen, and I will have justice.
It's mercy you need, sir, not justice.
Well, yeah, we'll see. Now go get me the owner and manager. I want to speak to him now.
Very well, sir. Hey, Mr. King, this man outside, he'd like to talk to you. You got time?
Yes.
His name's like Jack Mears, that Dare Tricks or something.
I know who he is.
Oh,
what are you doing?
Get out of here. Sorry. Are you the owner of this joint?
My father's the owner. I'm just the manager. But to get to him, you gotta go through me.
This is Mr. King, the manager of the Red Tie Club. Mr. King, Jack Mearstack Theatrix. He has a complaint he'd like to speak to you about.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thanks for coming out to me, Mr. King. I couldn't come into where you were.
No problem.
Well, see, that is the problem, though. Can't seem to get in. Mr. DeLaw here won't let me in under any circumstances.
Well, I admit, Mr. DeLaw here can be a bit intimidating at times, but that is his job. He must enforce the rules to the letter, keep all those out who don't meet the requirements.
But I can't meet the requirements, and I need to get in. You're the manager. Tell him to let me in.
Well, we couldn't let anybody in who doesn't meet the standards. That would be unfair to all those who already did.
Well, you see, I can't meet the requirements, so I don't know what I'll do. You write the rules, so just let me in.
Yes, and I must stick by them. Nobody gets in the red tie club without a red club tie. In fact, not just any old red tie would do. Must be a special one made by me.
Well, how can I get one of these red ties? Will you loan me one?
No, we don't exactly loan them.
Oh, I see. I'll just buy one from you?
You couldn't possibly pay what it's worth.
How does one get into your club, then? If I can't get in without a red tie, I can't borrow one from anyone, or I can't buy one, then what am I supposed to do?
Just ask.
Wait a sec. Ask? That's all?
That's it.
It cannot be that easy. Not after all this. These red ties are too costly to be free.
True, but they aren't free. A high price was paid for them. But I'm willing to pay and give it to anybody that asks of it as a gift.
But this is too easy. There must be a catch. I don't believe it.
Well, you must believe it if you're going to ask and receive it. Otherwise, you'll never ask.
So if getting a red tie was so easy, then why didn't DeLaw here offer me one earlier? He could have just got me in right away.
Well, DeLaw has no ties to give. He can only let you know that you need one to get in. I'm the only one that can get you what you need to get into my club. So ask and ye shall receive.
But don't you want to, Maybe check my background or something to make sure I'm worthy?
Your past doesn't matter to me, Jack Mirius. It's forgotten. Helping you build a brighter future is my goal. Once in, your association with me will affect all your dealings with others.
That sounds too good to pass up, but it almost sounds too good to be true. All right, I give up. May I please have one of your red ties? I would love to be a member.
Of course, Jack Mirius. But once in, you're more than a member of the club. You're part of the family. This is the beginning of a wonderful relationship, Jack Mirius.
Well, thanks so much. Now everybody will know that I'm a member. I'll wear it with pride.
Not pride, Jack Mirius. Wear it with joy. Then everyone will want to know where you got it. Then you can introduce them to me. I can get them their own red tie.
Sounds great. I'll do it.
Come on in, Jack Mirius. Your friends are waiting for you.
Welcome, Jack Mirius.
My man.
I love you, buddy. I love you.
Hits me every time.